morning.
This is God Stories Radio Podcast. God Stories Radio Podcast. With Fritz, Mike, and Tina.
You're listening to the God Stories Radio Podcast with Mike, Fritz, Trish, and Tina. Listen to us live on the Mixlr app. Also, be sure to follow us on iHeartRadio and you will never miss an episode.
And welcome, everybody, to God Stories Radio. This is session 155. I'm Fritz.
I'm Mike.
And I'm Tina.
What's going on, guys? It's Thursday night.
It is Thursday.
It's Thursday night.
The best day of the week.
And yeah. I feel so
Thursday,
right.
We're here. You bet.
Uh-huh.
We're here, and we're glad everybody else is here. That's awesome. So what's going on over there?
Riding a wave.
That must be a really, really long wave,
yeah,
Mike.
Yeah, it is.
Well, we love you, Mike. You know, we love to tease you.
That's the biggest wave I've ever seen.
Yes,
the
sir.
The never-ending wave.
It's a praise wave. That's why it's never
it
ending.
It's a praise wave. I like that.
Well, he's got me, again, wait for it, be still. So I'm on top of that wave, riding it, wherever it's going to, I don't know.
Okay.
Well, all right. We'll accept that.
What's about your week?
My week's been pretty fun-filled, action-packed. You know, when you work for the mouse, that's never a dull moment. We got the Star Wars half marathon coming up.
So. Oh, boy.
Woohoo.
Yeah.
I bet your hours are going to be funky then.
So my favorite t-shirt for the Star Wars half marathon that they put out several years ago was a picture of Darth Vader and it just said run. I thought that was so cute, you know.
That is cute.
Yeah, it was really funny. So
oh man, that is cute.
Yeah, they come up with some great merchandise items. They're so clever.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Well man, we just want to welcome everybody. Session 155. We don't have a guest this week yet again. But that's okay. I know the Lord is lining them up. We've got some in the wings. But I was talking with Mikey before the show, and there was just a lot of things that we could talk about, and we thought that we would possibly hit on the attributes of Christ and maybe thankfulness or
right.
Well, appreciation.
Like we did last week for our through our testimony, you know, it was... a forgiveness in regards to your testimony. And that's the, you know, Father gave me that. And the only other thing I'm thinking is, you know, hit some of his attributes. Again, when we sit down to do something like this, along with, you know, our testimony and what, you know, thankfulness would be one and whatever else we come up with.
And then
big, do that as well.
Big picture, too. We all want to be thinking about the fact that we should all be modeling Christ. We should all be looking more and more like Christ every day in our walk. And when I say our walk, I mean our journey, you know, in being a Christian. It's not just sort of, you know, sit back, relax, and, you know, don't worry about anything. It's you need to be actively pursuing a relationship with the Lord. And the key word in that is active,
mm-hmm.
Actively. You need to be physically doing something to push yourself to, you know, grow in his word, to be disciples of Christ, to show Christ to other people.
Man, you got your preach on tonight.
Yes, that's for sure.
Wow.
And some of those people that you come across, that may be the only Jesus that they see.
That's right, Mikey.
So
yeah, it's funny because in the car yesterday, I was saying the same thing to our 14-year-old, just telling him, you know, he was talking about a fellow student of his that we got the opportunity to bless him with a ride home. And his family has blessed our son with rides for months now, you know, and it's been super helpful to us. And we finally got an opportunity to do something nice in return. I mean, it can't measure up to what they did, but what they did for us was them demonstrating love in Christ. You know, and it was a pleasure to be able to spend time with this boy and just know that, you know, hey, I finally got an opportunity to do something back. Not that, you know, anybody's looking for payback.
Right.
But it's just nice when, you know, you can make an extra effort and help somebody else out. And most often than not, I find, even though my flesh doesn't necessarily want to do something, especially when it comes to serving, I always am glad after I have served and I'm like, oh man, I'm so glad I did that.
Mm-hmm. That's the truth.
Yeah. We've experienced that together too.
Well, yeah. Well, but your flesh will fight you.
Oh, it will. It absolutely.
Does. No doubt about it.
That flesh wants to be comfortable.
Well, you're not lying. That's for sure.
Yeah.
How does that saying go that, to bless someone or help someone that it's best to, that can't help you or pay you back.
Oh, yeah. I definitely agree with that. Definitely. And I always find almost, I'm going to go ahead and say it 100% of the time. I never say that, by the way, that I always walk away more blessed from serving than
absolutely
anything else, you know.
Storing up treasures in heaven.
Amen to that. Well, you know it's going to be good when your flesh fights you so bad.
It's true.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, I'm just lazy. I don't know about anybody else.
Hey, we're human, babe. We all fight that. That's for sure.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I know my favorite time of the show, the shout-outs. Who's going to start?
I'm going to start because
right.
This is one of my favoritest people in the whole wide world.
Oh, yes.
So I want to say thank you to Laura Davidson for liking Woo! Us on Facebook.
Thank you, Laura.
Thank you, Laura.
We love you, Laura, so much. Talk about blessing me. That lady has blessed me so much. Oh, my goodness. Couldn't even put it into words. And then another familiar name on this list is Matt Ellis. Matt, thank you so
much
for liking us on Facebook.
Yeah, Matt, thank you so much.
Thank you. I met him on Sunday in Easter with Dan and the family.
That's so cool.
Yes.
Yeah, Dan's been such a blessing. So we're just grateful for the whole family.
We are.
And then we have some new countries.
New countries.
Country number 87.
Country number 87.
Estonia.
Yeah.
Where's that?
It's near Finland.
Finland.
Wonderful. Wow. Marvelous.
Isn't that cool when you got to kind of look them up?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
I did. I had to look them up.
That's how far from Groveland is that?
Yeah, quite a ways. And then number 88.
Number 88.
88.
Slovakia. Yes.
Wow.
Man.
It's by Austria.
That's really, really cool.
Away. It is.
I'm just blown away.
And it's all, again, through Spotify.
Go Spotify.
Yes, sir.
Well, you're not kidding.
Yeah.
What a blessing that's been.
Guys, 88 countries.
88 countries.
Listening mm-hmm. around the world.
Wow.
It's very special.
But, very special. Yeah, you think it's, I mean, I can't. Beginning of the year, we were at what, 66 or 65, something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah. And we're at 88 because of, because Father pointed you toward Spotify.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I tell you. And then on that topic, our YouTube channel is growing.
Oh, wow. Very cool. Do you have some specifics about that?
I do. As a matter of fact, I have some new likes on YouTube. I'd like to welcome Beverly Rodriguez.
Thank you, Beverly, for
liking us and watching us on YouTube. And Diana Magura. Diana Magura, thank you.
Welcome. Thank you, Diana.
And if I don't pronounce this right, I'm sorry, Bruno Carniero.
Thanks, Bruno.
Thanks, Bruno.
Tracy Dunson.
Thank you, Tracy.
Tracy, thank you.
And then Nick, it's either Bada or Beta, B-A-D-A, Nick Bada.
Thank you, Nick.
Thank you, Nick. We appreciate that.
That's awesome. Wow, that's a lot of likes.
Really, I know, right? It is. That's our YouTube channel.
And YouTube. And remember, we have Faces for Radio.
We do. I know it. It's growing. Love it.
You know, I don't know whether or not to be offended by that.
We said that right from the beginning.
All right. Well, keeping with...
I got something over here.
You got something? All right. Well, yes. We'll send it back over here when you get done.
I will. During the week, I don't know if you sent it or it came to me automatically through Gmail, but, you know, we have people that push the button. And yes. Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
I sat down. I was sitting in my chair in my room, and the only furniture that I own too. And I looked at I had a Gmail, and I looked at it, and a woman, pressed the button, and she's on a monthly, $20 a month to God Stories Radio. As I was reading that, tears started to run down my face, and I'm looking up, talking, you know, telling Father, thank you. And I mean, it really, really hit me that unbelievable. And she writes, I listen to you guys, Tina and Trish, most every night, iHeartRadio. Regular folks with real Jesus-saving stories, whacked by a 2x4. We know she's been listening for sure. Your grassroots gift is worth supporting with my thin wallet. Hallelujah. And by all means, put my husband, David. So thank you, David and Jill, on your Lift Us on High list. We messed up on too many fronts and repeat just now. But ask the potter to throw us back on the wheel and create a renewed vessel to be filled brimming with his holy, perfect, proper, and plan.
Amen.
Blessings to you for bringing testimonials into all our lives. I'm very grateful. Jilly.
Jilly, David, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Gosh, that means so much to us.
It does. And I just had a minute or two there sitting in that chair, just tears running down my face.
Well, I see you still get emotional just even reading it,
right.
You know?
It just, wow. So, again, thank you, Jill and David. Pray that the Lord blesses you.
And just so you guys know, some of the things that your donations go towards are things like equipment upgrades and purchases. You know, there's costs associated with running a studio, internet things, and, you know, the different platforms that we're on. We're on quite a few different platforms. Fritz has mentioned before taxes, et cetera. Just a lot of things to do with, you know, it's basically like running a small business.
Correct.
So, you know, all the costs that are associated with that. And then sometimes God Stories Radio chooses to bless people as well. So
we have done that, yes.
Yeah. So, you know, it's a multitude of different ways that your dollars are going, but they're definitely going to glorify the kingdom. So these 88 countries that are listening, if you've supported us, you've definitely been a part of that. And you should feel just as happy and excited and elated as we do, because you helped grow the kingdom for Christ. So thank you all.
Thank you. Again, laying up treasures in heaven.
Amen to that.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Thank you, Jill. Thank you so much. That just, man, the whole thing just touched our hearts. It really did. In keeping with that theme, I'd like to thank a few people. Kenyon Gatlin, remember Kenyon?
Oh, I love Kenyon. Yes.
Well, Kenyon's been giving... regularly every month, little bits here and there.
Right.
But a couple of weeks ago, she gave $100.
Oh, my goodness.
And I missed her last week. I'm sorry, Kenyon, but I wanted to to give a shout out to you and say, you know, thank you so much.
Yes.
It being tax time this time of year and everything, we take a pretty big hit financially. And it's so nice to have the support from brothers and sisters out there so that we're not footing the bill, you know, ourselves, mm-hmm. well, which we would gladly do. And we did for several years right. because mm-hmm. we're only here for one agenda because the Lord told us. Mm-hmm. And that's to bless people and whatnot. So
and we have a new person doing our taxes this year.
Yeah, that's been a challenge in itself because
it has.
I had the other lady trained, which was nice because I could just drop off the paperwork. So if she saw Mixler, she knew what it was. Right. If she saw Adobe Audition, she knew what that was, right. you know. But this lady, no clue. So I had to go educate her what everything was, wow. and we sat for about an hour and a half. But now going forward, she'll be good, and next year will be a lot easier. So we're getting down to crunch time, but I think we're going to make it.
All
I think
right.
we're going to be fine. But keeping on the theme of Matthew Ellis...
Yes.
That brother just gave another $10.
Oh, thank you, Matt.
He's always stepping up, man. Love that guy.
Yeah.
I'll tell you. And we want to thank Dan. I'll leave it at that.
Yeah.
He gave us a gift.
Dan, you're such a blessing. Thank you.
He came by and handed me a gift at the front door. That's how he rolls. And a thank you again to Jill. And who Mikey just spoke about.
Jill and David. Yeah.
And what? Jill?
And David.
David, mm-hmm. her husband.
Oh, and David.
Mm-hmm.
That's the Gil Hart.
Gil Hart.
I'm sorry, Jill, if I mispronounced that. All right. Big shout out to Mr. Craig at Craig's Carpet.
Oh, Craig.
Yeah, $100 bill.
Thank you, Craig.
Craig, you're awesome. I only wish you lived closer.
I know.
You know, but we'll talk about you. And
he lives kitty corner in the other end of the country.
He does.
You ain't lying. I'll tell you. You talk about being blessed from the four corners of the earth.
Uh-huh.
He's over there. But thanks to all of you for the gifts. It is greatly, greatly appreciated.
Absolutely.
You know what I love too, babe, is that all these folks become family to us.
As far as I'm concerned, they are.
Absolutely. Yeah.
That's, I mean, when you got people showing up at your front door to hand you money, they're family.
Well, you have these people on Mixer that they, you know, one of them in particular keeps going, are you all going to be on tonight? You got something going on tonight? But, you know, that to know that there are people there that can't wait to just like we can, or can't wait to Thursday night, they can't either. And I love that.
Yeah. Amazing.
Yeah, I got that text this afternoon from that individual. Guy's going to be on. And he did text me a few minutes ago. Mixer's not working. Well, yeah, it is. There's other people on and they can hear.
Is this the same individual who had some issues with Mixer last week?
Yeah. I think so.
Okay, gotcha. Well,
is everybody on Mixer hearing us fine?
Yeah. My buddy Tom is on right now, and he says that he could hear fine. It's all good. And then, Mark, if you happen over there, I think Mark's on YouTube with us. So I think he's just graduated over to YouTube.
Awesome.
Okay. How we look on the big screen tonight, Marky? You're a blessing, man. I enjoyed your chicken salad.
We have a couples Bible study with them once a week, and it's such a blessing to us. You know, we have a good time with them. And they just make us laugh all the time.
Yeah, we love you, Mark. Couples Bible study rocks.
It does. Yeah.
Singles ministry's rocking.
Yes, it does. Yes.
As a matter of fact.
We were all serving at Helping Hands last week, Saturday, which was cool.
Big shout out to the Rev.
Oh, Gary.
Yeah, he's smooth. He is. And I'm going to explain what I mean. I just felt led to go to one of my very spiritual places today, at a Waffle House.
Oh, really?
So when I got my blood work done, I meandered over to Waffle House and I sat up at the bar. As opposed to sitting in a booth.
Mm-hmm.
It's a breakfast house, folks.
Yeah, Waffle
it's
House. Everybody knows the Waffle House. Yeah. The bar at Waffle House. Anyway, Jen, who's a waitress there, you know, they're all waving at me when I came in because they know me very well. But anyway, Jen says, do you know this guy? And I went, oh, the Rev. Like that. And she laughed. She said, why do you call him the Rev? And I said, well, you know, he just got ordained a couple of months ago. So I nicknamed him the Rev.
Mm-hmm.
And anyway, she said Gary's been after her for years.
Really?
And she wouldn't give him the time of day. And then, you know, then she ended up at the singles ministry.
Right.
Boy, did she give me a hard time. She says, everything I start coming, you don't come back. I'm like, no, I'll be back. You know, I've had to work and some other different issues. But so they, Gary's been after her and she finally relented and went out on a date.
Wow.
You know, and then one date turned into two, which turned into three. And I said, well, I said, you got to tell him to take you out for coffee.
Yeah.
And you got to say it like that, coffee.
Coffee.
Yep. He will know exactly where that came from. You got to do it. Absolutely got to do it for the Rev. But, you know, congratulations, Gary. And we'll have him back on the show. He's a regular.
Yeah.
He comes and talks about his prison ministry and everything. And I handed out some cards. But I said all that to say this. I was talking to Jen about the podcast.
Uh-huh.
And I was saying how we didn't have a guest this week. And the guy sitting next to me goes, oh, I'm a great speaker. I'll come on your show.
That's awesome.
Really? And he said, what kind of show is it? And I said, well, it's a testimonial-based podcast called God Stories Radio. And man, his eyes perked up and his wife's eyes perked up. And he goes, you're kidding me. I said, no, it's not. And I handed him a card. And man, am I glad I got those cards in
me
the car.
Me too, babe.
In the car. Anyway, he goes to a church. He's been to Real Life several times.
Okay.
But then he goes to a Baptist church out in Groveland where they have, I guess they have started a ministry to... I guess women that have had abortions and unborn babies and things like that.
Yeah.
And, you know, they provide homes and solace and stuff for these ladies that have been through it.
Right.
Kind of almost what Janet Dara does.
Yeah. Yeah. Very similar.
Didn't Mo Midlow do something similar or Beauty for Ashes?
Yeah. No? Possibly.
Okay.
And I had the brochure and everything to show you guys. But anyway, they're moving right now. They just sold their house. They're moving to another house.
Uh-huh.
And he said, as soon as they're done with the move, he's going to call me.
Oh, that's awesome.
And get booked. Him and his wife are going to come in and talk about that. So we got some things in the works.
Right.
You know, but Father's just had us, you know, talking to y'all, getting to know everybody out there and just having a good time. And we love it.
But let's pitch testimonies. Right now.
What is a testimony, Mikey?
Oh, what?
You know, we throw a lot of terms around on God Stories Radio, just kind of thinking that people know what we're talking about. Well, maybe there might be somebody sitting out there going, they keep mentioning this testimony. What is a testimony?
Right.
You know, what do I have a testimony?
Right.
To give. So we have something on our website at godstoriesradio.com, which you can go and read. And Mikey's got it pulled up now. So
I do.
I'll just go ahead and let him.
Well, it was. Session four. All right. And when we do have guests, we kind of ask people to go listen to session one and session four to get an idea where God Stories Radio came from, how it was birthed, and then what is a Christian testimony. And I sat down with Father it was a Tuesday afternoon, and it would be 5 years ago in another month or two, and I spent the afternoon and... A Christian testimony could give encouragement, hope, and comfort to someone experiencing difficult and hard times. The Christian testimony could give one the courage to persevere and to carry on, to see the goodness of Jesus Christ and his glory. The Christian testimony could have one think, if he will do it for them, he can and will do it for me. The purpose for us as Christians is to tell our experiences and how we came to know Christ so the listener who does not know Christ or may be experiencing some of the same or close to the same situations being discussed or heard. The Christian testimony should cover the before you came to know Christ and how he got your attention. That's the 2x4 beside the head. Then the changes that happened
as a result of Christ entering into your life, possibly something that could only point to Christ as an explanation.
And between that and session four, that's what came up with that afternoon on Christian testimony. So anyone out there listening, if Father is tugging at your heart to give your testimony on God Stories Radio, again, we can read it if you write it to us. We can do call-ins. We can, we'd love to have you sitting right here next to me.
And, you know, it doesn't have to be your life story. It could just be a portion of your life. You know, it's really just to, you know, show how God showed up and showed off in your life, you know. And all of us have those moments in our life where, you know, you were either walking with Christ and something took you down, or, you know, this was before you got to know Christ and how he came into your life. So, you know, everybody's got a story, and you might not think it's significant, but you never know what's significant to somebody who's listening.
Absolutely. Amen to that, babe.
Yeah. You know, some of the most powerful testimonies have been those people who said, oh, there's nothing special that happened in my testimony. My testimony is really boring. Yeah.
There's always someone out there that is going through something that you're going through.
Absolutely.
And I was seeing on the opposite end of the spectrum, I've seen people come in here with pages of notes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just highly detailed, outlined, you know, bullet points of their testimony and never use it.
No.
Now they just put it to the side and they start talking.
And I sit here and I watch the change, the Holy Spirit take over. And I can see it almost every time in a person when they, especially, well, not even if they have papers, but I can tell when they're sitting there and all of a sudden the Holy Spirit takes over. It's awesome to watch.
Man, it is. Mm-hmm. It is great.
Yeah, I've just, you know, I was thinking the other day how blessed we have been to meet all these guests that have come in person, you know, mm-hmm. to just be touched by their lives. And just the mention of their names will bring like a smile to my face or a warm thought.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's such a privilege to be a part of the whole thing.
Absolutely.
I just can't wait to get here on Thursday night. I can't wait to get back. Now, you know, I just feel like there's people out there that we're connecting with and they count on us, so to speak. And we count on them, you know, for encouragement and the regulars.
And
you
we're
know,
getting we it too.
Really, really appreciate them. And, you know, yes. Tom's on, my buddy Tom's on right now. And I appreciate him. He's faithful to tune in.
Yes,
and
he is.
I know he's busy. He's got things to do, but, you know, he's faithful to tune in and to listen and, you know, I would take a bullet for that, brother. And I'm thankful that that he's at my job, you know?
Yeah.
And I think the Lord placed him there strategically.
Yeah.
Because we kind of need each other. I mean, we both, you know, bounce things off of each other. We might come in and have different things going on different days. So
that's like me and my girl, Kat.
Right. You got to have a cat in your life.
Yep.
Yes,
my friend
you do.
Kat.
Yes, you do. I was kind of, you know, praying about what to talk about tonight, and the Lord put a song in my mind. I don't know if you've heard the song "Arise" by Chris Sly.
Oh yeah, I love it.
Yeah, but along with that theme, I couldn't believe how many scriptures there are that deal with arise, just the word arise. But there's so many variants of that that you could just get off and talk about different things. One that came to mind, I was talking to Austin today, and he goes, man, you know, conflict is a perfect thing about to talk about associated with arise. I mean, how do you arise out of conflict? And actually, the Webster's Dictionary talks about arise being, you know, how you stand up or you lift up or you get up
mm-hmm.
during conflict. Mm-hmm. And I thought that was interesting. So one of the points that Austin and I were talking about on the phone today was, you know, he a big source of conflict, and I'm really guilty of this, is not appreciating what you have, is not appreciating what God has done for you. And, you know, you're always uptight about what you don't have, uptight about what you can't afford, uptight about what God hasn't given you, mm-hmm. uptight because you don't have enough money, you know, uptight because you're not doing the ministry you'd like to do, uptight because you don't have a wife yet. Hashtag Mikey.
Well, it's funny you say that because I had one of those mornings yesterday.
Yeah.
I did.
Yeah.
I just let it go. But usually when I do that, it lasts for days. About an hour or so later, I said, okay, that's enough. That's it. And I cross, okay, let's move on. And it just went in.
Good for you, Mikey.
Who was
Father, forgive me for the sin that I just committed by, you know, talking with you the way I did. And you know, where's this and how come that and so on and so forth. And you know, like I said, it usually lasts for days or hours. And I just let it go for about an hour. And I said, okay, that's enough. That's it.
Honey, was it Francis Chan that was saying that whenever he feels attacked like that, what he's noticed is that usually his prayer life is not where he want, you know, like where he'd want it to be. And then as soon as he starts, you know, recommitting back to praying, it like goes away.
Absolutely.
Was that Francis Chan? Okay.
It was. And when he gets into that, Mikey used to call it, he would just say, I'm in a bad place.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And he never would have to explain that because anytime I talked to Mike, he'd say, I'm just in a bad place. And you just know that you're in between and you're having to, you just need time to sort out and deal with those feelings.
Yeah.
And what you
were saying, you touched on about three or four different things that I went to him about yesterday about, you know, how can I do this because I'm not making enough money to do that? And you know, you mentioned the wife thingy and so on and so forth. And I, you know, it just went off, you know, where is it? You know, how come I can't take it anymore? And so on and so forth. And I says, you know what? That's enough, Satan. You're out.
Good for you, Mikey.
And stomped right on it. Probably about an hour. So I was proud that, you know, I didn't let
I'm it, proud of you.
Didn't let
Because I remember when that used to, that's, you'd seethe on that for days.
Yeah.
And then you'd let it sometimes take you into a bad place.
Mm-hmm.
And you kind of doubt where is Father and all
right,
this.
You know, with after I went back and you know, confessed and everything else, it was just like, I was fine. And then, of course, I had today off, or I was supposed to have today off. And one of the things we talked about yesterday was not enough money to do this and do that. And, of course, they called me in this morning. Blue. So I know where that came from.
Mm-hmm.
But
it's the royal bone.
Uh-huh. He listened to me.
He got the bone.
Uh-huh.
I love it when he does that. I'm praying for a few things right now that the Lord would throw me a bone.
Uh-huh. I just told him I was really, really, totally frustrated at this point. And then I just, okay. I'm good.
It doesn't do us a lick of good to
no
to stew on it anyway.
No.
It really doesn't. Goodness gracious. Well, that was kind of the nugget that I had today. What you got, babe?
No, I was just wondering about the song. So I know better than to debate songs with you.
Yeah, really.
Because you win every time.
I was going to ask him, why did he give you a song?
Well, yeah, he gave him a song because he's musically inclined, right?
That's
like the best way to reach him.
Right.
But I was confusing it with the song Rise by Danny Gokey.
No, not the same song.
Yeah.
I think I was too.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember Arise. How does it go?
I'll play it for you.
Yeah.
Afterwards, and then you'll know it right off.
Yeah.
But the Z used to play it way back when.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a kind of a, not an oldie, but a couple of years ago.
Yeah. And they used to play it at Real Life, you know, pre-service and stuff like that.
Oh, so if I heard it, I'd know it. Okay.
Yeah, but I went right to it. You know, I just, boom, right there.
Mm-hmm.
Chris Sly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And
not Danny Gokey Rise.
Yeah, Chris Lai.
Although that is good. That's a good song, and we've used that on past...
Chris Lai was on American Idol, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He's amazing.
He really is. He's got a beautiful voice.
Well, the song he's probably most noted for is Empty Me.
Mm-hmm. I love that song. Oh, my goodness. I love that song.
Oh, yeah. I never get tired of that song.
So where were you going with Arise?
Well, I think after I saw that definition today about the conflict, that's how I got into the conversation with Austin, and we got off on a whirlwind about appreciation. So it's kind of like, without appreciation, there's conflict. And then it kind of goes full circle, you know. And I was convicted myself because I have to stop and appreciate what I have and where I've come from.
Mm-hmm.
Because I will create my own self-conflict by doubting the Father and asking him, you know, where are you in this? Why are we broke? Why am I driving such an old car? Why do I go through this on my job?
Uh-huh. I know.
Mutter.
I know how you feel.
And I think that all stems from a lack of appreciation. I think when you're content, conflict is minimal. And, you know, I mean, there's some conflict you just can't avoid. But I'm thinking if you're content and you really walk in the peace that passeth all understanding, that, you know.
Got to be like Paul, baby. You got to find contentment in all circumstances. You know,
he said he was poured out like a drink offering, but he was happy as a clam.
Right. And you know, I think I could be, but, you know, I believe I have these promises that have been given to me. And I think it makes it tougher because you're trusting and waiting and believing on these promises, and they're not forthcoming, in my time, of course. And, you know, so... You get to that point, you know, I thought about it when I was yesterday. I says, usually about every 2 to 3 months, I hit that point. And it was that point yesterday. But again, I think I could be content if I didn't have those promises.
Well, it's like Tom Petty said, the waiting is the hardest part.
Oh, it is. I'll guarantee, I can... Stand on that for sure. Waiting.
Yep. That's for sure.
And you mentioned the word conflict. Nobody has any of those, right?
No. I don't even know what that is.
But, you know, and I read something today or yesterday that, you know, when you have these constant, you know, you're in these constant conflicts and everything, Father's working something. He's... toning something and changing you in something in some way. So
he always said every Monday night and at group, I don't know why this sounds so fuzzy, but he used to say that the Lord will tighten down the screws until he gets all of you.
Right. He'll squeeze.
Yep. He will squeeze until he gets it all. And sometimes your time to deliberate is over. It's time to squeeze. He's absolutely. Like, you can't, if you're going to go to the next level, I'm going to step in.
You got to feel the pain.
Right. Mm-hmm. And I kind of think that's what I've been going through personally. I feel that way. I feel like I've had the screws put to me, you know, and he's tightening down. And it's a good thing if you can see it as that.
Right.
Is the only thing you see it as the blessing that it is and not the curse. Hey, I see Matthew Ellis on the Mixler.
Hey, Matt.
Hey, bud. We were just talking about you. You betcha we were. Mikey, would you say about Matt?
I met him on Easter Sunday at church.
Oh, that's right.
Real life.
Excellent. So you met Sir Mikey.
Sir Mikey.
Well, Matt, maybe I'll get over there and meet you sometime too. I don't get many Sundays off, but I have a feeling that's going to change. I don't know why. But also wanted to thank you for your $10 gift that you gave recently. I saw that. Appreciate it. Thank you so much, Matt. We love and appreciate you. Thank you so much. Thanks for listening and being an integral part of the GSR family.
Thank you so much.
And today, we did not have a guest, so we are talking about appreciation and conflict.
Arise
out of that conflict. And how do you arise out of that conflict? With appreciation.
Yeah.
Well, it seems like, you know, being grateful and, you know, actually physically speaking gratitude to the Lord will start changing your perspective.
Mm. Amen to that.
Changing your mood, etc. Yeah,
that's for sure, man.
You know, a lot of us get really wrapped up in feelings, and we have to be very careful about that because feelings are extremely deceptive. Mm-hmm. You have to remember it's not about how we feel. You know, it's about what God knows is best. And we have to put our trust in the Lord that He knows what's best for our lives. He tells us over and over again, His plans are to prosper us, to do good for us, you know, and, you know, we who know how to give good gifts to our kids and people we love, how much more is He, mm-hmm. you know, that He can give us even more. So, you know, it's hard. I know life is not easy, but we have to take everything, even those tough circumstances. We have to remember to be obedient. We have to take those tough circumstances and look at them as opportunities that God is using to grow us spiritually. Mm-hmm. And how you come out on the other end of that spiritual growth really is going to be much more amazing than where you went into it. And, you know, it might have been painful and uncomfortable, etc., but it's not going to be forever. It's for a season. You know, we don't know how long a season will be sometimes. Sometimes it's very long.
That's true.
But all we can be assured about is that at the end of the season, God has used it to benefit us.
And others.
And others, yes.
I'm going to buy your tape, babe. You got a book coming out or anything?
Yes. No, just kidding.
So, well, Matt weighed in on the chat, said he can't wait to meet all of us.
Oh, that's awesome.
I can't wait to meet him.
Likewise.
As well.
Definitely. It'd
be wonderful. I can't wait to have him on the show.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah, absolutely.
He said someday, right?
Well, did he say that to you? I don't know that he...
I don't know. I thought he said it at some point. It will happen sometime.
Did you say that, Matt? Weigh in. We can't talk about you in front of you.
No pressure.
No pressure.
No pressure, but we need a guest next week.
We do have one.
We have one next week.
Oh, do we?
Yes,
okay.
We do.
We're going to have Sir Johnny Blankenship in here.
Oh, Johnny.
And Bo Duke.
Bo Duke.
Oh, cool.
And
cool,
they will be hopefully bringing their guitars.
Oh, I hope so.
I'd love for them to do a duet of some kind in here.
Oh,
that'd
yeah.
be great. And we're going to be talking about tithing.
Oh, great.
He already told me.
Fantastic.
He already told you.
Convicted about tithing, wants to come in and talk about it. And I can't wait.
Yeah.
Well, those are two of the most talented guys, man. I'll tell you what. I've had the privilege of playing drums with them and worship and ministering with them, and they're just amazing.
They can definitely play the guitar.
Ooh, you ain't kidding. You are not kidding.
Johnny's got a great voice, too. I love to hear him sing.
Matthew says, yes, and my fiance, too.
Yay!
All right. Woo!
You know, and that makes me think back on Mixler about a month or so ago, there was some person by the name of Anderson on there. And he mentioned he was going to give his, you know, he was thinking about giving his testimony, and I...
Is that your friend, babe? Is that your friend?
Anderson. I know who you're...
He was on Mixler.
Yeah, and I know who you're talking about.
When he said that, then I called him out basically right there on air. And I don't think you've seen him on there since.
I haven't seen him since.
Sorry. I won't do that again.
Yeah, he was a regular.
He was.
We scared him.
Oh.
I don't want to scare anybody.
No. I was just looking for testimonies, that's all.
Yeah.
We need testimonies.
Yes, we do. We also need listeners. Oh, man. Well, we just appreciate our listeners until they finally go, hey, can I give my testimony? Well, I'm glad you asked.
Like you said, though, we have a bunch in the hopper.
Yeah, we do. And it's going to be a good year. It's already a great year.
Sure is.
And I'll be honest with you, I've really enjoyed these sessions.
Yeah,
just talking with you guys, talking with the listeners, interacting, you know, chatting, stuff like that. It's been awesome.
It is. I mean, I think interactive is the best kind of conversation. So, you know, when we hear from folks, it's nice. It becomes, you know, more like we're all in the same room.
Amen to that. That's for sure. Well, guys, that about wraps it up for session 155. Thanks for hanging out with us. It's been about 45 minutes.
All right. That's good.
Believe it or not. And if we spent the whole 45 minutes just giving praise to the Father and thanking everybody and having appreciation, it was all right with me.
Yes. It was a beautiful way to kind of do a show.
Amen to that. All right. Well, I'm going to wrap it up. We appreciate everybody listening. Thanks to everybody again that supports us. And we just love each and every one of you. And we hope that you have a great week. And we're signing off now. That's session 155. I'm Fritz.
I'm Mike.
And I'm Tina.
God bless.
God bless.
God bless.
Stars go down in the western sky. The light fades. As the darkness dies.